Alright, so let's go for a game. Alright, opponent's taking a very long time for no apparent reason. Okay, well, let's take a look. I think there's a keep. I got ramp, I got some cantrips, and I also have paradoxical outcome when I draw into more lands. So hopefully this will be a turn for a win, if nothing goes wrong. I'm gonna keep that. Okay, that's usually a bad sign, blue-black. Probably some Delver deck. Alright, let's run the island out. Keep the opponent on their toes. Pretend I have a dispel. Is this some sort of Tron? Some sort of Mindslaver deck? Sword of the Meek. Okay, now I'm kind of confused. Okay, got my second Ephyrium Sculptor. Pass it back. That's what happens. I'm thinking I probably have to blow up the... Oh, Bitter Blossoms. Why you do this? Why you do this? Alright, fine. Have your way. Let's run the Ephyrium Sculptor out. And now I can cast all of these guys for free. Start with the Eco Wellsprings. See if the opponent does anything. Let's play an island. Let's just run them all out. Come on, man. You just have six. So ran out my whole hand, got a grip full of nothing, but hopefully I would have gone for all my lands here. So pass it back to him. Don't think I'm going to die quite just yet. I'll get hit for a bit pretty soon. See what he gets. He gets a Hallowed Fountain, right? And taps. He gets himself a fairy. Alright, can't figure out what the new commands are. F3, that's what it is. Alright. Just keep the appearance up that I have a negate in my hand. Yeah. Press F4 only. That's what he does. Flooded Strand. Alright, so back to my turn. Let's play Phyrexia's Core. And let's do Paradoxical Outcome, targeting all these artifacts. Okay. Hopefully it resolves. Oh boy, he's got a counter. Path to Exile. Sure, buddy. Let's get a mountain, just to scare him a bit. I don't have anything until I sideboard. Alright, so let's see what I got here. A lot of nothing. Great. I think at this stage, I'm going to attack and send a message. Block me, bro. Block me. Try and block me. F6 here. Ooh boy, losing the one Furium Sculptor is pretty bad, but on the bright side, I got Panharmonicon, got my Anvil, so I should be fairly set. Okay, I'm gonna discard some cards. This is the least useful one. Okay, hopefully I have the game. Next turn I'm gonna cast Anvil, Exiling the Metalwork. And I can get Panharmonicon, and then I get all these artifacts down. So if he doesn't win this turn, I should be set. Four, five. Oh, six damage. I'm okay with that. That's not lethal. Okay, so draw an Eagle Wellspring. That's even better. Gonna cast a Semblance Anvil. Please don't have a counter spell. Just once, please. No counter? No counter? Yes! Alright, now we're in business. So I'm going to exile Metalwork Colossus as soon as he lets me. Come on, buddy. You'll be fine, don't worry about it. It's not going to hurt you. Alright. Exile the Colossus. And cast Panharmonicon. Pay one. No counter. Just one time. No counters. You could just stop pretending. You got one blue mana. Chance of you having a counter for it is pretty slim. Come on, buddy. Get the least useful artifacts at first. actually should have cast out first. Maybe that's a good thing. Maybe I'll force him to F6. I think I'm gonna run a panharmonic on out and see if I can bait a counterspell. And if he counters it, then I'm in the clear. Alright, I think, I think I'm in the clear now. Yes. I'm gonna auto yield this. And draw 3 cards. For free. Alright, 21. And draw 3 cards. Come on. Come on. There you go. You should have the F6. Just don't worry about it. Shh. Just let it happen. Alright, living the dream right here. Yeah, paradoxical outcome. Not really necessary. Okay, let's run a... Oh, I don't have... Yeah. Let's run a Mind Stone out. Twice as much fun. Okay, I think let's pay 50 life and let's bean him for 50. No, I don't want to redirect it. Alright. Okay, let's see. I think the Metalwork Colossus is pretty useless here. I'm gonna take into the Galloper Aether and also to the spells, because I'm pretty sure I'm gonna start running into counter spells. For maybe a Mind Stone. And run it back. 2 reservoirs, 1 land. Definitely gonna mulligan this. Okay, I got ramp, I got some draw. I think it's a keeper. I'm gonna probably bottom this. Land's not really something I want at the moment. Serum visions, okay. So this is a bit of a tempo deck. That gets scary. That was a slow round for him. Normally at that stage they should have kind of been in control of the game by then. Alright, run an island out. Pretend I have a dispel. Hopefully I draw into one at some point. Because I definitely want to use that and guard the Aetherflux Reservoir. Now that they know that's my win con. And taking out the Colossus is pretty bad too sometimes, because that's my alternate win con. Okay, and crack a Marsh Flats and see what they get. A Watery Grave. Untapped. What are you planning to do? Inquisition. Feel free, buddy. Nothing that great. Does take a Sculptor, unfortunately. I'd actually be more worried if they took the Wellsprings. because if they take the wellsprings, these are actually kind of useless. Alright, I'm fine with that. Okay, so right now I have no action going on for me. I'm gonna leave that for now, because I do want Semblance Anvil to exile an artifact. Alright, some visions. Feel free. Enjoy your visions. Alright, so should be my turn again. Let's play the anvil. The question is, I think I want to exile the reservoir for now, because essentially it's not doing that much. I'm drawn to other stuff. I think I pass it here. Okay, Godless Shrine untapped. Ugh, Stony Silence. Okay, that resolves. Activated abilities. That could be a problem. Do I have a win con? Yes, I do. I still do have win con technically. Because I have the Gilliper Aether, I can tap my artifacts to ping him for one. So technically I'm not dead. I think I'm gonna save on the paradoxical outcome. I want more lands first, because he still technically has enough mana for negate, although he's never actually countered a spell so far. Spoke too soon. Well, it's not a counter spell. You get the point. Okay. Question is, do I want to use the paradoxical outcome? I mean, the Semblance Anvil, I can exile the spell, so it only costs two. Draw a whole bunch of cards, and I should draw a ramp spell. Tapped out, and I can't do it now. I think I passed for now. I think I need a bit more information about what I'm dealing with before I keep going. It is a fantastic opportunity that they're tapped out, and this could be a bit of a mistake, but I'm gonna risk it a little bit to see what they're doing. A little bit more before I decide, because I'm in no danger dying at the moment. I'm still at 20 health. And they're 13. Stony Silence. Okay, that's fine. Alright. let's bounce that back up. If I get a Ephraim Sculptor, I could plant it all back down as well. Okay, let's see what they're doing. So they're not doing anything? They're just literally cracking. I am going to dispel that. There's chances are I'm going to have to discard a whole bunch of crap anyways. Okay, so two, four, five, six, seven. I got exactly seven currents. All right, I think I passed the turn for now. I still got a semblance anvil in my hand, and I don't think my opponent actually plays any counter spells. By this stage, they still haven't done anything, any counter or disruption, really. They've been reliant on inquisitions. So it's a bit of a budget deck, I think, for my opponent. So, flashback Lingering Souls. Pre-combat, somehow. I'll take two. It's fine with me, seeing as you dealt way more damage to yourself than I did. Alright, let's play Phyrexia's Core. 3. Let's play Semblance Anvil. Oops. I tapped for one extra mana I didn't need. Sound Kaleidostone. That's the least useful one out of the bunch. Spring. Let's put the Efflux Reservoir. Now, I know that I can't bean him in the head for 50, but this does give me life. So this should keep me alive for a good little while. And beaning the spirits for 50 also seems like a bad idea. Especially when it costs me 50. Oop, Panharmonicon. Do I want to pay one right now? He's got no counter spells at the moment. I think I'll just pay one for now. And then now I start drawing two whenever I draw a card. Or at least whenever one of these things drop. Paradoxical outcome. I think I pass for now. then during my opponent's end step, should I sack it? No, I shouldn't. Alright, I'm gonna F4. Let's see what I do. Can't block it, but I highly doubt you're gonna kill me with two measly spirits. Yeah, I think I just pass my turn. I'll pass until I get to my turn. See a paradoxical outcome. Gain my first life of the day. Come on, just let it resolve. Just this once. Yes. Okay, let's see. Let's do, ugh, need one more mana. Cancel that. Let's see if I got... No, Mind Stones. Did I just take it all out? Did I play land yet? Yeah, I did. Alright. Okay, not a big deal. I'm gonna do a Semblance Anvil. And I'm probably gonna exile a card. No, for the first one is got two triggers from a Panharmonicon. Gonna exile the prism. Oops. Exile the prism. Okay, so now things should be free. Let's cast a Aetherflux Reservoir. To watch out because I'm going to start running pretty low on the library front pretty soon. Oh, whoops, did I go through my attack phase? I'm okay with that. Okay. Let's start beaning him, send a message. All right, not enough artifacts. So one. That's one damage. Here's here's my second damage. Here's my third damage. Fourth damage. Fifth damage. Alright. I'll just finish this off then. Oh, am I missing two? Missing two cards, really? It's okay. No 300 something life. No. No. 387 life. Oh my goodness. Can I even go any further out? I'm just kind of curious. Yep, I can actually. Let's just see how far I can go. Ooh, this is getting dangerous. Oh boy, that is hilarious. Alright, won the game.